SCOTUS considers our right to bear arms openly. This is our topic report, and the video title is going to be Supreme Court to Determine If We Have Right to Open Carry Our Arms. And the topic is Supreme Court New York Gun Case Open Carry. And we have selected our first link here comes from thedenverchannel.com. Supreme Court agrees to take up gun case regarding right to carry for self-defense. And this is an excerpt from thedenverchannel.com. The Supreme Court has agreed to hear an appeal to expand gun rights in the United States in a New York case over the right to carry a firearm in public for self-defense. The case will be argued in the fall and marks the court's first foray into gun rights since Justice Amy Coney Barrett came on board in October, making a 6-3 conservative majority, allegedly. I wouldn't consider Justice Roberts a reliable, quote-unquote, conservative, and it's a shame that all we have are conservatives and progressives on the Supreme Court, but that's a whole other can of worms to talk about. The justices said Monday they'll review a lower court ruling that upheld New York's restrictive gun permit law, and this is connected to, as we said, it's connected to the right to bear arms. Now, what's interesting about this case is I believe that the Supreme Court has essentially for a long time been looking to punt ever since really the first last major ruling was the Heller ruling. And the Heller ruling kind of equivocated somewhat, but shot down Washington, D.C.'s attempt to basically make it impossible for human beings to have guns in their homes that they could realistically use to defend themselves from intruders. So the Supreme Court, the way that I view the Supreme Court, on one hand, the Supreme Court really doesn't want to empower we the people to have the right to bear arms that we actually have, regardless of the Constitution, regardless of the Bill of Rights. This is a God-given right, the God-given right of a human being to defend themselves realistically within the context of the reality of power that the world possesses that day. So today we're talking about guns. Tomorrow we could be talking about drones. Whatever tools we can utilize to defend ourselves, that's where the issue lies. It's not guns. It's tools of defense, really, is what we're talking about. And the Supreme Court has no desire, because they come from the political power classes, and it's those people that they're still very much cozying up to, very much a part of, and they have no accountability at this point because they're there for life. So on the one hand, they don't want to empower we the people, but on the other hand, they don't want to tick us off. So they'd rather punt. They'd rather continue to punt. Now, finally, SCOTUS is actually taking up a case that could theoretically have significant ramifications both for or against the people, and it will be made clear the nature of the government we have based upon the ruling that the Supreme Court might come to. My suspicion, and I'm a little uncertain on this, but my suspicion is that we will get some sort of half measure ruling that checks New York somewhat, but leaves the door open for other states to continue to control our ability to defend ourselves. That's the situation that's at hand here. So I'm not sure that we'll get that decisive ruling one way or another, but I will say if we get a ruling that comes out strongly against, that opens up the door for widespread gun control, I think a lot of conservative states, Republican-controlled states, I should say, that may give them pause. And I don't know the ramifications of that. I don't want to lead too much into that, but there you have it. And that's my brief analysis. Now, this article here, this headline here and everything, the way this is written for the Denver Channel, seems to be a site that possibly is in favor of gun rights. Just because this was written kind of neutral, it's kind of neutral, but let's look at more headlines. So here we have opinion, uncomfortable timing for a Supreme Court gunfight from the New York Times, of course. The New York State Rifle and Pistol Association case challenges the state law that limits most licenses to carry a gun outside the home to those applicants who can show that proper cause exists. The statute does not define proper cause, and judicial interpretations over the years have defined it narrowly. And let's see, why is this a bad time for because of quote-unquote gun violence, most likely. Let's see what they say. Try a few more stories for free. Whatever, New York Times. If you don't want to let me see, then I won't see. So there's that. Supreme Court declines to hear case challenging lifetime gun ownership ban. So I wanted to show this because you see where they're punting. This certainly, why are they not listening to this case? Well, I don't know the details. There may be some, whether it's a technicality, which is often what they try to do, some technicality where, well, you just don't have a right. You're not really an interested party or whatever the phrase is. The Supreme Court says it won't take up cases about gun ownership for people convicted of nonviolent crimes. Absolutely should. Absolutely should. And I'm 100% for human beings, whether they're felons or not, if they've committed nonviolent crimes, if they've done the time, they should get their rights back. They should be able to vote. They should be able to buy guns. A column from WKPW.com, and just a couple more headlines here to go over real quick. Gun advocates watching Supreme Court case. This is from Table Qua Daily Press. Ask PolitiFact, is the Biden administration pushing for no-knock raids to seize guns? Well, sure. Maybe not directly, but I'm sure they said no. Supreme Court passes on three Second Amendment cases, USAtoday.com. Supreme Court takes up case which could give New Yorkers right to carry guns in public, independent.com, the Independent UK. And finally, Supreme Court to take up right to carry guns for self-defense.